So we've been going through James chapter 5. There's a particular verse that continues just to stick out to me and calls, I believe, for some very practical application in our lives as we respond to the various things happening around us. What is it? Stay tuned. As I said, I'm continually struck by James 5, verse 7. James says, "So be patient, brothers and sisters, until the Lord's return." Of course, the context is he's encouraging them toward patience in the midst of the atrocities that they're experiencing from these rich landowners, the oppression that they're receiving from them. It could be fellow believers. It could be individuals, unbelieving, though Jewish people as well. Either way, there's a call for patience. There's this call for this long-fused attitude toward them. And it got me thinking in many respects, a number of things coming together. Much turmoil, of course, in our nation. In regard to political leaders, and there was, you know, a lot of concern, a lot of we might even call uprising, protest toward them, toward what some individuals would perceive to be injustices that are that may actually be. That's another debate for another time. I'm not going to get into that today. But patience isn't always necessarily our strong suit, is it? When it comes to anything we experience, any kind of injustice or oppression. Now, I'm not talking about the ignoring the laws, ignoring times when people have indeed broken the law and need to be taken to court, when we have DAs and prosecutors that do that. I'm thinking more so on the fact that we take things into our own hands sometimes, don't we? I think of David as he writes in Psalm 13, in the midst of these oppressive time, a time of oppression in your life, a time of great trouble, a time when you feel like you're being wronged, perhaps you are, you're experiencing injustice. Maybe we're like David in Psalm 13, where we start questioning the Lord. God, you've called us to be patient, but then he says, "How long, Lord, will you continue to ignore me?" Sometimes it feels like that, doesn't it? As we're waiting on God's timetable. How long will you pay no attention to me? How long must I worry and suffer in broad daylight? How long will my enemy gloat over me? Look at me, answer me, O Lord, my God. David was not shy about his passion, not shy about his communication to the Lord. And seeking answers to the questions that plagued his life, particularly when he encountered harsh times. And we may feel in that same place at times, don't we? In fact, so much so that we feel God is being too slow, so we end up taking things into our own hands. Perhaps we speak in a very critical spirit, and in an essence of judgment, and trying to get back at the person who is has some injustice against us, speaking foully, speaking unkindly about them, when in reality maybe we don't have a basis for that. Maybe we're not waiting long enough for what God might do, or maybe there's something within us we need to deal with. Sometimes we see individuals maybe take action that would not be Christ-like. God calls us here. There's a number of avenues you could take that, and I encourage you to explore that personally. What I want to focus on here is specifically the patience. God calls us to be patient, to have this long fuse, if you will. And I just left Psalm 13. I needed to be there. Come back to that. The word itself is in the aorist imperative, which essentially then the reader is James is calling the reader to just do this. This is something that must be done. If we are believers, we must do it. We must be patient. Of course, we can only do this with proper support and with a proper perspective. And he encourages that perspective to look to the Lord's return. And the support is, of course, the Spirit's supernatural power within us, enabling us to hang on, if you will, as one person had written. This is not a command to try and hold on to with our own power, because if we do, we fail, don't we? We speak something, we do something that we shouldn't. But God calls us, he gives us this command to be patient. He doesn't call us to anything more than what he himself already is. Ephesians chapter 5:1 calls us to imitate him. We see time and time again throughout the book of Proverbs, these calls to be slow to anger. We see God himself in his dealings with Israel to be a patient God. Time and time again, he is patient. He calls us again to look beyond, as he gives us command to look beyond. In fact, David himself comes to that end, or that conclusion in verse 5 of Psalm 13. But I trust in your faithfulness. Amidst the difficulties that he's going through, amidst the these unanswered questions, this, you know, God, why aren't you acting when I want you to? He looks beyond and remembers the basis for the hope that he has, the faithfulness of God, and he says, I will trust you, Lord, in this circumstance. I don't know what you're doing. I don't know how long it's going to take. I don't know if you're going to answer it in my way. But I will trust your faithfulness. That's to his character. That's to his justice, his holiness, and all that he might do in response to what we're going through. But he says, be patient, brothers and sisters, James says, until the Lord's return. I appreciate someone making this comment that God knows that what we are looking for will impact what we are living for. What we're looking for impacts what we're living for. When was the last time you pondered the truth of the Lord's return? When was the last time you allowed that to guide your decision-making, to guide how you responded to a particular situation or crisis? The author calls this vertical vision. And the point is that the vertical vision should impact the horizontal living, just as James calls them to here. Be patient, horizontal living, with that vertical vision, the Lord's return. I encourage you to that today. He is coming. Jesus says, he says, I wouldn't have told you so if I weren't. He is coming again. And that hope, that promise, gives us focus, gives us something to look forward to, and is meant to impact our day-to-day interactions with people and with the world around us. Let's have vertical vision today. Until next time, friends, God bless.